the surprise from later on, which when it's gonna be, but we're going to Yuna. We're out like at 5 a.m. today.
Yeah.
So we're a bit tired, but it's gonna be exciting too.
Yes.
So we're here in the ferry now, enjoying our coffee on the counter. So Lil Yachty's album just came out.
Yeah, like a week ago or something like that.
Yeah, and it like really blew me away.
Yeah, we both love it so much.
Yeah,
it's like really good.
It's kind of like you talked to Tyler Crater. You got some inspiration from him.
I heard he hung out a lot with Drake too. Like recently, like he lived with him for like a month or something.
Yeah. Yeah, it's like kind of a punk 70s, I would say, in a way.
Definitely, yeah.
Which song do you like the best?
I think Pretty is the most iconic song.
Yeah, yeah.
It's
it
the
kind
one
of
that's
reminds me of the Poland.
Yeah, it's very much still Lil Yachty, but you know, it has this new sound too, which is like perfect, like it fits so well together, it's crazy.
But I will say like the album is good to hear it together.
Yeah, exactly.
Listening to it like since it came out, like every day, like all the time.
I open up Spotify, I'm like, what should I put on?
Yeah.
And I just get so happy whenever I just like start the album. Like it's very cinematic too. It's
everyone should go listen to it.
Yeah.
And I think it's a new like fresh spark to a rap.
Yeah.
I think like the industry is really boring right now, so I think it's a nice touch. Actually, I don't even like Lil Yachty that much normally.
No,
he's pretty good. I think he's underrated for sure, but the new Lil Yachty is that's me.
Yeah,
that's good. That's
the new. Yeah, I think the first right when he came out like back in the day, it was like fresh and like fun.
Mm.
But this is like now he's a real musician.
Yeah, for sure.
Before it was kind of just like fun thing.
Yeah.
So we're here now?
Yeah. As you can see, he has a lot of G-Wagons.
They're all
like
vintage,
this one.
Yeah.
Got all the old cars here. It's like, I think it's Germany. German military cars.
German military
wagons.
G-Wagons.
Yeah. And he restored them and you can like make an order and ask for anything. Like, if I wanted matte black, with some cool rims and I don't know, get it all tinted up and sent to even America, so all you folks can also hook him up.
We'll, oh shit, that's crazy.
We'll link his Instagram, and he's super talented, super nice guy, good prices. Okay, as you can see, this is my old car. I'm probably gonna miss this color actually. It's grown a lot on me. It kind of has this purple tint. And I'm gonna keep my rims. I love these rims. So it's an upgrade, but it's actually, this is from 1994, and the new one is from 93.
Okay.
So they're actually older.
Okay, so we're here in his garage.
Garage, yeah. And his where he does all his work.
Are all of these his?
It's all his. But not like for private, for
No,
for
but
sale,
like he's working with these cars.
Like his collection is so sick. Testarossa Ferrari. So fucking clean. Everything's like, I don't even want to touch it. And he got the Porsche 911.
Yeah.
But this is super iconic. I need this car in my life someday. This
is
G-Wagon.
A gold car. Yeah.
Kind of green, greenish color. Really nice. I like how unique all these cars are with the interior. And this is some seats you can put in the trunk where you can actually sit more people. So you can sit like two people on each side. This is where the new car is.
This is the original rims I'm gonna get with the car, but I'm gonna put my old rims on. Maybe for summer or winter I can use these. This is one of his projects right now. Super interesting. Looks like a Daniel Asham project or something.
If we locked in, ain't no switching up. Brody came home, went to pick him up. Nigga killed my mans, I'm riding with a picture up. Shoot back to the crib, went to pick the switches up. Stole the track hard, got it tinted up. Caught him outside, now he in a blunt. Ain't no falling off, I done put 2 million up. Nigga, ain't no falling off, I done put 2 million up. Catch his ass at the light, like Tupac and hit him up. Ain't no life after death, nigga, you ain't big enough. Know them youngins mean business when they in their rental truck. They gon' spin till they dizzy or the police pick them up. I been staying on the
way. This is a pretty wild car. And you can hear the engine in the back.
This car,
so actually this is called the Widowmaker because it's like so it's so wild when you drive. It's like
right
all over the place, drifting, and yeah, so much horsepower.
I can feel it. It's pretty crazy. Yeah. It's fun.
Really amazing experience to drive this. It has always been my dream, actually. Want to own this one day, but I have to learn the gears. It's really the manual stick here is like,
this is also so old.
I feel like the new ones
will be much easier.
Yeah,
but very very smooth.
Yeah,
very powerful car.
Really powerful. Really really fun. Like yeah. I really felt like I drove. Kind of love the interior, the exterior. Everything is
pretty sick. Superb.
Porsche makes the best cars for sure, no doubt. So sick.
Yeah. You just took like a small ride in it, just like 100 meters.
Yeah, it was super nice.
What would you say?
Like it's a step up, like more Rolls Royce feeling.
Yeah.
You know, the V8.
Yeah.
That's better. You can feel the 8 cylinder for sure. Super cool.
You gotta let me drive it at some point.
Yeah, for sure. I can drive. So as you can see, like 2-tone, gray and black. Sunroof, got the wooden details, super nice.
Okay, so we're here at Aarhus.
Yeah, museum in Aarhus.
Yeah.
And gonna check it out. It's supposed to be like the best museum, things like modern art. Yeah. Like a fresh amount of pain. I shoot a photo that green.
What's the verdict on that one?
That was crazy. It was really like weird. You playing the piano or something. Okay, it's supposed to be like catastrophic. Everything far, there's no meow meow ocean burst.
Meow meow.
Whoa.
episodes trip with this place. It kind of gave me this dystopia, utopia, Chernobyl vibe.
This room is sick.
Yeah.
This is where Kanye is mixing his beats right now.
It's the Donda Mercedes Stadium vibe.
Yeah.
It's like wax or something, right?
Yeah.
Super cool.
Japanese house.
Yeah, and it also really reminds me of Vietnam right now with all the rain.
Oh yeah.
Mexico.
It's so scary in here.
Yeah, it is. It's like 40, you can feel the thunder.
Yeah.
And the rain is here and the... Yeah. It's like being here. In real life, I'm scared.
Like a rainbow certain thing you go around here.
Yeah, I've never been here before. It's quite nice. I feel like I've seen 1,000 pictures of it online.
Mm-hmm.
You see so many people go here, especially this circle here.
Yeah.
So it's nice being here.
It's actually real nice, I think.
I think it's some of the nicest installation art I've seen, especially that room with the rain.
Yeah.
That was like, I had emotions in there. I was like, wow, this is crazy.
Yeah, that one was crazy. I feel like the skyline here is so beautiful in the daytime. Tree of life.
I think this is just a regular tree.
And then we got the camber. This is kind of like William's camber.
This is quite sick. All of these hunger and like homeless signs, I guess, from different parts of the world, and then framed in this super nice frame. There's like
this contrast.
Yeah.
What's this?
This is all my underwear.
Your laundry?
This is my laundry. They have a laundry service at this time, so thought I'd drop it off here.
If you don't like Denmark, goodbye. Fuck off. Go home. Kind of aggressive.
I mean, everybody loves Denmark, so this is a sign for no one.
Mm-hmm. Oh, we found your boy.
Yeah. My son, my long lost son.
Oh shit, he's kind of scary, right?
Yeah. I feel like they moved him. I feel like he was out in the lobby area when they first started it.
But he can walk himself, you know?
Yeah.
So maybe he's just here for now.
He's sitting very still.
Yeah.
Don't move.
Don't move. I feel like this is the main attraction for this museum. It's really well known, this.
I think we should do the drive-thru.
Okay.
That's the first thing you do when you get a new car. You go to McDonald's. You fuck it up.
Let's see if the window works today.
Okay, here we go.
Hi.
Hej, velkommen til McDonald's. Hvad er det, jeg
har? En teambox. Kan du godt tænke mig?
Ja, en mix der med nuggets.
Bare nuggets. Yes. Hvor meget er det, der er en teambox?
Der er 18 stykker i.
To.
Okay, dem skal vi have to af.
To af dem?
Ja, tak.
Okay, so...
Getting ready for the final meal.
For the final meal of the day. We just had dinner, but...
It wasn't enough.
No, it wasn't enough.
It was like too fine dining for us, actually.
Yeah, we're very hungry.
Yeah.
So.
I should have done the order in English just for the vlog, actually, now that I think about it.
Yeah.
But now you guys can learn some Danish. Successful day. Got a lot later than expected. Got our nuggets, McDonald's, to finish up, to wrap it up. And got the car, so heavy. Went to a museum as well, really nice museum. Tried the Porsche 911. So now we have a long trip ahead of us home.
house.
Yeah. But I guess we just have to finish it at 80%.